From the very beginning, the Victory Tour was designed to be the biggest, the richest, and the most expensive concert tour in the history of rock and roll. Everything about this tour is on a monumental scale. The men and materials, the costs, the potential revenues, even the heat. The numbers are mind-boggling. It's like some video game score going berserk. $40 million for the Jacksons, $60 million for promoters, 22 tractor trailers, 2,200 lights, 750,000 pound stage, 9-story towers, 240 custom speakers, 18,000 amps of power. When the something starts, security coordinator Anthony Davis is the man in charge.
We're taking great steps to ensure the proper safety of the patrons and the production and the band.
What kind of numbers are we talking here in terms of security people?
Kansas City, we used over 300 t-shirt and 145 police. We're going to use similar numbers here at Texas Stadium for that show.
What's normal?
A Rolling Stones or a Who or a Bowie type show, we would use similar numbers, similar number in terms of the major tour.
Now, I was emceeing the show in Kansas City, as you know. And when I was standing backstage, I got the feeling that I was in jail. I couldn't get out, and I couldn't get in at times when Michael was backstage.
That's the key. We have to ensure the safety of the artist, and that's primo. You don't have a show unless you have your artist.
How many security people travel with Michael personally?
He has a staff coordinated by Bill Bray of, I think, about 8 to 10 people from Los Angeles that coordinated for the band personally.
And they're with him always?
Constantly, right.
Whose job is it to secure the glove?
That's our responsibility. We coordinate the on-site lockup security. That would be our responsibility.
Is there any one person who has to stand guard of the glove at all times?
There have wardrobe people. Our responsibility are to lock up that area and to secure the room, yes.
Did you have any incidents in Kansas City?
We were pleased with Kansas City. We had small little things that occurred, but nothing that we could work out. We're hopeful and we're confident that we can do a good job in securing the stadium and providing the proper crowd control and venue security.
Now, for future dates, are you going to increase the security?
We have advanced teams out right now. Pete Kransky, my superior with Contemporary Services and Stadium Management, is out now advancing the different dates, and he's looking at the stadium, making the contacts. Like when I came here, a lot of the program was already laid out as to what are the things that needed to be done, and my job is now to pick up the ball after they start the ball rolling, and I pick it up and carry it out through the shows. So we do have advanced teams out looking at the venue, looking at the staff, getting a feel of the neighborhood, just to see what potential problems we might have.
But the biggest rock and roll event in history has also had the biggest problems. And I mean right from the start, the Jackson Tour has had big problems.
Something tells me that the Jackson 5 are in deep trouble, man.
That's funny, little brother, because something just told me the same thing.
With less than 6 weeks before the tour was to open in Kansas City, a promoter had yet to be signed, and the entire fate of the tour was being endangered. Victory was turning into defeat. Then, at what seemed like the last possible moment, a deal was struck. Chuck Sullivan, president of Stadium Management Corporation and owner of the New England Patriots, emerged as the winner of this intense bidding war. Other than your wealth, what makes you qualified to promote this kind of show?
Well, we feel we have over the years worked quite actively in sports promotion. We've also had some experience in music promotion, and those experiences coupled with the great staff that we have that's working on this really provide the basis for this effort. I mean, the fellow who is the key person on our staff, was also the key person for the Police tour last summer, Doug McNeil. And that was the most successful music tour in the history of the world.
How did you get in on this deal?
We got in on this, our company got involved in this through the efforts of Frank DeLeo, the manager of Michael Jackson. And Frank had suggested that Stadium Management Corporation make the bid, and we did, and it was accepted.
People have said that Chuck Sullivan is a greedy man.
Well, I don't share that viewpoint, but my main objective is making sure that these shows are produced successfully for the enjoyment of the fans, and I think that that's what's going to happen.
Well, I think you're a nice guy.
Thank you. I think you're a nice guy, too.
Okay.
I'm Tom Joyner, and we'll be back right after this. Although the problems inside the tour were being resolved, a new battleground was developing with the press, particularly the Dallas press. And every day, new salvos were fired at the promoters. Charges and countercharges like gunfire were exchanged. Chuck Sullivan and Stadium Management Corporation, the promoters, were on the defensive.
You've been roasted pretty good in Dallas, in the newspapers especially. They're saying that you guys really haven't sold out the show. Have you sold it out?
Well, you got to realize my background is I'm the former general manager of the Eagles. And that's not the rock and roll group or the singing group. That's the Philadelphia Eagles. So we've been roasted in Dallas before. In fact, we've been roasted at Texas Stadium before. You got to look at this in perspective. I think we're guilty of not being we're just able to give the information out because we've physically been here trying to launch the Kansas City show. And for that, I apologize to the Dallas media. But I think there's a lot of misunderstandings. There's going to be a major press conference at noon today.
At first, the promoters planned to ban any and all press coverage of the tour. But of course, I wasn't going to take no for an answer. I wanted an interview with the Glove himself.
I know that Michael Jackson is staying in this hotel in that room. Security is real tight. It's impossible to get to him, but I'm determined. I'm standing in the rain trying to get an interview with Michael Jackson. I might get lucky right now. Just a minute. Michael, it's me, Tom. Wave your hand, anything.
Good afternoon. We thank you all for coming this morning. As you know, we have all the Jacksons here, Randy, Tito, Marlon, and Michael. All right, Michael has a statement that he'd like to read at this time. Michael?
Can I have silence for a minute, please? A lot of people are having trouble getting tickets. The other day I got a letter from a fan.
You know.
Yes, great. Thank you.
Okay. Are you sure? A lot of people are having trouble getting tickets. The other day I got a letter from a fan in Texas named LaDonna Jones. She'd been saving her money from odd jobs to buy tickets. But with the current tour system, she'd have to buy 4 tickets. And she couldn't afford that. So we've asked our promoter to work out a new way of distributing tickets, a way that no longer require a money order. I've asked our promoter to end the mail order ticket system as soon as possible so that no one will pay money unless they get a ticket. Finally, and most importantly, there's something else I am going to announce today. I want you to know that I've decided to donate all my money I make from the performance to charity. There will be further press statements released in the next 2 weeks. Thank you very much.
What charity? What charity will you donate it to?
Not decided. The charities have not been decided yet. There are a few that are in consideration. We'll further that later on with further details.
Is there a possibility?
There it was, a nearly inaudible 43-second glimpse of Michael Jackson. Needless to say, an already hostile press was not satisfied. However, later that evening, the Jackson and Sullivan families hosted a press party. It was filled with the usual speeches and small talk, but it did have its highlight.
You know, it's a hard job covering the Jacksons tour, but it has its benefits. We get free food, free booze, free tickets, and we get a free t-shirt from a Kansas City Chief cheerleader, the Chief Ends. Thank you, Michael, baby. We love you. Tom Joyner, on the road with the Jacksons. The Jackson Tour has had a problem with its image, and in order to improve it, they've decided to give away a certain number of tickets in each city. They're to give these tickets away to the economically disadvantaged and emotionally disabled. Here in Kansas City, that responsibility fell on the mayor's office. But you know, that could be a political liability, because although there'll be a lot of kids very happy, think of all the kids that will be disappointed.
This is Michael Fisher in Mayor Berkeley's office, calling to let you know that the Special Olympics have been selected to receive some of the tickets, free tickets for the Michael Jackson, Jackson's Victory Tour.
When we first were given this responsibility by the promoters, we decided that the job was really too big for this office and that we could not be involved in such short notice, only a week to 10 days notice, on individual ticket requests. So what we have done is turn the responsibility over to agencies and organizations within the Kansas City metropolitan area who serve us directly, those young persons.
I understand your phones have been ringing off the hook. How many requests did you get?
We invited the public, we invited those organizations and agencies to call us and tell us about their organization. We received over 9,000 individual requests for tickets, and we only have 1,500.
I'll be back in a moment with an exclusive interview with Randy Jackson himself.
You're a whole new generation. You're loving what they do. I put a pencil in the holes, and that choice is up to you. Hey, you're the best generation. Because the diamond is the feel of the day.
Really appreciate you coming on the show tonight.
Oh, thank you.
How you like Texas heat?
Oh, I love Texas. The heat, I'm used to the heat. Where I'm from, it's always hot.
What about when you perform tomorrow night? How will you deal with the heat in Texas Stadium?
I've been training in the heat. I've been jogging every morning, and it's hot. So that helps a lot when it comes to performing. Working out in the heat and builds my endurance. So I'll be ready for tomorrow night, I think.
Other than jogging, what else are you doing to?
Oh, we play a little basketball, do a little bicycling, and little things like that. Just keep fit, toned.
Okay. What about the rest of your brothers? Are they jogging and doing the same kinds of things to stay in shape?
Well, sometimes. Not as much as myself, because I have to. Because I had a serious car accident a few years back, and if I sit down too long, I won't be able to move. So I have to keep fit and in shape, because my legs, they'll just give out on me if I don't keep in shape.
I remember that accident.
Yeah.
In fact, you missed the last tour because of that accident.
Well, I didn't miss the last tour.
No, you came on it anyway, but you didn't do a lot of moving around.
Exactly. I sort of stayed back a little bit. Take it easy, because I didn't want to mess up anything permanently. So I took my time.
That was pretty scary.
Oh, yeah. It was very scary and very serious. That was a big turning point in my life, that accident. You know, I don't know if it was something that was meant to be, because at that point, it gave me time to stop and relax and think about what I want to do with myself and my career. And so now it's all of that's taking effect, you know, the time that I spent concentrating and thinking a lot.
You probably had to also think about, what if I'm paralyzed? Because at one point, reports were out that you were partially paralyzed because of that accident.
I was paralyzed, and there was an amputation stage. But like all the stories you hear, you know, supposedly, you know, you never let that bother you, which I, you know, I never let that bother me. And I kept positive, and that I didn't want any negative things around me, you know, nothing negative. So I kept a positive mind, and everything happened correctly, or better, you know.
What about Kansas City, the three nights in Kansas City? Were you satisfied with the performance?
I was totally blown away, because that was the opening of the concert tour, and I was very happy with everything. I think that was our best first show we've ever done in our careers.
You had to feel the pressure, because the media from all over the world was there watching this, even live on ABC.
Yeah, I felt the pressure before the concert, but once I hit the stage, it's like there's no pressure, because I'm most at home on stage, and I feel that that's what I know best. And that's almost natural, you know, for me. You know, it's like everything comes natural once I hit the stage.
This mammoth production, this huge production that you guys have got, what part did Randy play in putting this all together?
Well, we worked together a lot on this production. I was the first one actually to start. I started with hiring the band and the musicians. And I worked with the band, and we went over all the songs, trying to reproduce every exact sound as much as close as we could to the records, and maybe even better so than the records, just to get a live, exciting feel to some of the songs. That took a while to
do
that.
You pulled it off real well, too, considering that, let me see, I saw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe 6 pieces up there. How many pieces are there?
Well, let's see, there's 3 keyboards, including myself, a drummer, and 3 guitars. Nah, that's 7. And bass, and that's it.
Yeah, and 8.
4 keyboards, I'm sorry.
To reproduce a sound that when you go in the studio consists
of strings and horns and stuff like that. So it was tough, you know, every guy's playing different parts and his hands going like this all the time. So, but it works out real good.
When did you start working on it?
Well, I started working on the band, speaking. Mm-hmm. Oh, let me see. I guess we started around, we started about 3-4 months ago working on that. About 3 months ago working on the band, as far as the auditions, hiring, and then the rehearsals. Working all day, Saturdays and Sundays, and just working hard. Because it means a lot to me, this tour, and I want everything to be right. I want people to enjoy this. I want to sound good. I want everything to be right. And if for any reason I think something's wrong, I will work hard to correct that, you know.
And what are you going to do after this? The answer to that and other questions when our exclusive interview with Randy Jackson continues in a moment.
I'm 5'10 with a 26-inch waist. My PS guitars are proportionately sized to fit me.
He's in charge of the band. What about the other brothers?
I'm not in charge of the band.
Oh, yeah. I thought maybe everybody had their own role in putting this together.
I guess you can call it being in charge. Well, because I'm probably the most concerned with like, all the guys and how everything's going musically, and all the music and the songs, you know. mm-hmm. making sure that they sound right. Mm-hmm. Everything comes off right, and the sound and the quality and all that. I get really involved with that.
I guess what I was getting at is, since this is you know, a family, I thought that maybe everybody had a designated role. What's everybody else's role?
Well, Marlon and Michael, they were good at the choreography and working that out.
Mm-hmm.
And Jermaine helped us out with his songs a lot because this is his first tour with us in 8 years, so we needed some assistance there with certain things. So we've been working hard at that with Jermaine. And Tito's, he's helped me out with the band some, mm-hmm. you know. But I like working with the band and the music because I think that is the most important thing of the whole show, is the music. That's why we're here.
Now, you're the youngest of the nine children.
Mm-hmm.
What do you remember about the Jackson 5 era?
Well,
you weren't around for the Jackson 5 era. Well, you were around, but you weren't on stage.
I came in after ABC, but what I remember most is wanting so much to be a part of that. When I was a little kid.
How old?
Oh, I must have been seven. I started when I was eight. So I just wanted to do anything just to be up there, experience that.
You were seven, and what was out then?
I Want You Back.
So they were already?
Yeah, they were. I was in Indiana, and they were...
Everywhere. What's life like, living like you live, with all the security, being able to go out? I've always wondered that.
I try and do as much as I can as a normal person, you know. I like to go out and see things, and I've been out in Dallas, you know. I've driven around. I went to the mall, the Galleria.
Did you get noticed?
Yes.
What happened?
Well, I have this person that comes with me. His name is Charles, and he takes care of the situation, but he's a real nice guy. Sometimes. But it's fun, you know. I like talking to people, you know. I like talking to people from different states. You know. I like communicating with people.
Now, you guys have been getting blasted in the press. Mm-hmm. Especially here in Dallas. I think more so in Dallas than in Kansas City anyway, because I was in Kansas City. What is your reaction to the press that you've gotten here?
Well, I think...
Do you think it's fair? Do you think it's unjust?
Well, I was afraid to come to Dallas because I thought Dallas, the old Dallas was upset at us. I mean, I was going, boy, how am I going to go to Dallas? Because... Everything was focused on Dallas, you know, all the press with the tickets and all that. And when I came here, I felt a little more comfortable because everybody made me feel at home. even when I went out, and people had nothing bad to say to me, just they were really excited and couldn't wait for Friday night. And I hope that everybody will be happy, you know, when they see the show, and then they'll be pleased. But as far as the press, I don't have to look or read because it's there. I mean, it's there. I mean, you hear it when you turn on the TV or the radio, and you hear it, and you hear the negative things. It's something of this magnitude. There's got to be negativities, and sometimes they're exaggerated. Sometimes, you know, they're not. I think this is exaggerated, and it's not as bad as they say it is, because I think no matter what course we would have chosen, as far as the tickets being dispersed, I think there would have been negative press, you know, because of the tour being so big. I think there would have been negative press regardless of anything. So it's something that people go through all the time.
Now, I've seen all three of the Kansas City performances. I've been backstage, I've been on stage. I have witnessed how much stuff you guys have got up there. I know you have a tremendous...
Which is coming on tomorrow night?
Yeah.
Okay, don't tell them too much.
I won't tell them too much.
Okay.
I will tell them this, that this concert is the most elaborate production that I've ever witnessed. You guys have got a stage that will looks like it'll do everything but fly. Will it fly?
No, it doesn't fly. It's real simple.
It doesn't look simple. It's huge. it does all kinds of things.
A lot of work.
It must cost a lot of money.
Actually, it's very inexpensive.
Really?
I'm joking with you.
You mean I could buy a stage like that today? I could afford it.
We got it on wholesale.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. No, it costs a lot. It costs certainly a lot. I mean, I think that the public deserves the best, as far as I'm concerned. And when we do the stage, we want it to be the best. So it costs us a lot of money. And we don't mind doing that for the people. We want them to enjoy it themselves.
And what are you going to do after this?
I'm coming out with an album myself.
I like the tunes on the Victory Tour that you on the Victory album.
Thanks.
Yeah. And what are the other brothers going to do when this is all over?
Producing their production projects. Marlon's doing a movie. Jermaine's probably will do another album. He may produce Whitney Houston, who's singing on his album. I think he's going to do something with her. So every brother has.
And Tito.
Tito, he's incredible talent. He's building his studio at his home, which he's doing most of it himself, and he's working on that.
And Michael.
And Michael, I think, may do a movie.
Are you guys going to ever tour again?
I would like to, but it's very hard to see that happen.
When you invite a man out to a nice place for lunch, you really mean it.
May I show you to your seat, sir? This is our most popular patch of sunshine.
Let's start with a drink.
Diet Pepsi?
Diet Pepsi. Great taste with NutraSweet.
I'm sure it'll be to your liking. Yes?
Yes. To everything with no reservations.
You don't need reservations, sir.
Taste improved by Diet Pepsi.
Miller's Power Punch is the fashion answer. Miller's Power Punch is the fashion answer.
You wanna feel good? Do you wanna look right?
Miller's Output is the fashion answer.
Do you wanna get hot? Do you wanna excite?
When you want the latest in fashions or just your favorite pair of jeans, it's Miller's Outpost, the fashion answer.
Miller's Output is the fashion answer.
The Masters of Suspense are on Channel 21 weeknights beginning at 10 with Alfred Hitchcock Presents.
That's precisely why I don't care for Russian roulette. I never seem to win.
If you prefer underhanded crimes, then we've got your man.
You've been dead for 7 long years. Don't you understand? You are dead!
Then at 10:30, Rod Serling's Night Gallery is here to lighten up your late nights. Got any doubts?
Carrie, what is it?
Something wants me dead.
Serling really knows how to put on a show. Don't be too nervous.
No. No, I must know.
Just watch Channel 21, weeknights starting at 10.
Talk, talk, talk. Enough already. What about the concert itself? Well, while we were in Kansas City, we shot a little footage for you to see right now.
How you feel?
When the world is on your shoulder, gotta shake them up, crack them through the night. If they can't get me the feeling, then I make no wonder how I'm going to die. For me to party for night and day, seeing it crazy, that's the only way. Show tonight.
Let the madness and the music get to you. Love is the way that I'm.
life. If you take the chance and do it, then there ain't nobody's gonna put you. There'll be this party for night and day. Living crazy, that's the only way.
Have fun. You can't tell them to sit down. Get up if you want to. Do whatever you want to do. We're here to have a good time. The next song we're going to do is one of my favorite songs. It's an Academy Award nomination and a Golden Globe Award. Wait. Hold it. Wait. Listen, we've been doing this song for years and years. I'll tell you what, for a change, give me something new.
Reaching out, safety wings to sleep beside. Get me out into the night. For walls won't hold me tonight. And if this town is just an apple, then let me take a bite. If they say why, tell them that it's human nature. Why does he do me that way? If they say why, tell him that it's human nature. Why does he do me that way? Reaching out, whistling. Electric eyes are everywhere. See that girl, she knows I'm watching.
Because it'll be that way if they say why. Tell them that it's human nature. Why? Why does it be that way? I like living this way. I'm loving this way.
Nutrasweet. Life just seems to get better and better.
Diet Pepsi Free.
Diet Pepsi Free just added something they call Nutrasweet. I call it terrific.
Diet Pepsi Free.
Diet Pepsi Free with Nutrasweet. Everything in life should be this good.
And all that taste is caffeine free.
Terrific.
We are Pepsi Free.
Regular and diet.
You know, we'd have lost the herd if it weren't for Nissan. That hunk of 4x4 muscle come out of nowhere and blew right by them steers.
Nissan, most standard power in the class.
Cut them off, quick in a quarter horse.
Tough, independent front suspension and the tightest turning circle of any 4x4.
Probably never seen nothing like that again.
Come alive, come and try it. Major Motion.
No.
At your Datsun dealer.
Loves proudly announces refastenable tapes.
You fasten and refasten in just one step.
It's Loves' new one-step refastenable tapes.
It's the one-step tape that refastens great.
Just peel back slowly and refasten.
Here and there, anywhere.
So don't be left behind. Get Loves' new one-step refastenable tapes.
It's a one-step, one-step, one-step tape with one-step tapes. Loves are great.
America needs the very best. The finest engineers.
Quit testing it today. It'll work.
The bravest soldiers.
Get out of the way. We're having some problems with the tank.
And one of the best comedies of the summer.
He said for 50 bucks he told you to a gas station. You're so funny.
Dudley Moore.
Genius is an overused word.
Eddie Murphy. Best Defense.
Starts Friday, July 20th in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. Check your newspapers for showtimes and listings.
They came from everywhere. Short ones, tall ones, fat ones, small ones, all shapes, sizes, every race, religion, every age group. They all came to bear witness to that one Michael Jackson. And looking at them walking outside of Arrowhead Stadium, you could tell that they had the tune of Billie Jean in their head.
She told me her name was Billie Jean.
Dallas, Texas. I came up to Kansas City just to see the Michael Jackson show with my cousins here. And I thought the show was fantastic. If y'all miss it, you're making a big mistake.
I love Michael Jackson. Fantastic.
Did it hold your interest?
Yes. I liked it very much.
Did it hold our interest? What do you mean? That was fantastic.
Yes, I enjoyed it.
Pretty good, man. Real nice. Real nice.
I said they left too quick.
Great.
It's awesome.
Back again. Still back again.
Very good. Very good.
I thought it was beautifully done.
You normally go to concerts like this?
Never do. This was my first, and it was thrilling for me.
Is Dallas gonna like this show?
Yeah! Is there any part of the concert you didn't particularly like? Would you pay $30 again to get in?
You're a whole new generation. You love and want to do. I put a taxi in the boat, and that choice is up to you. Hey, you're the best generation. Cause the diamond is the beautiful.
Tonight.
Well, there you have it, an inside look at the Jackson's Victory Tour from KC to Big D. I've been fortunate to be chosen as the MC for the Jackson shows, and I've had the unique opportunity to see what goes on behind the scenes in this musical event of a lifetime. In my opinion, this will be the last hoorah for the Jacksons. It is doubtful they will ever go on tour again as a group. Each of the brothers will probably go his separate way. As far as all the controversy concerning ticket prices and such, well, I believe Randy, when he said the Jacksons are not going to walk away with the kind of dollars being speculated about in the press. I'm glad to have the opportunity to play a small part in this tour, and I hope you've enjoyed our bringing it to you. What's the bottom line? Is it worth it? Is it worth the $30 ticket price and all the trouble that you had to go through to get it? I say yes, if you're lucky to get a ticket. And if you weren't lucky to get a ticket, who knows, maybe one day it'll come on television for free, but don't count on it. I'm Tom Joyner, saying good night, and maybe I'll see you at the concert.
Tonight's special look at the Jackson's Victory Tour has been brought to you by Pepsi, the choice of a new generation, and by Miller's Outposts. Friday night at 8, Steve McQueen heads up an all-star cast in an unusual World War II story full of action. It's one infantry squad against the entire Nazi line. Hell is for heroes. Friday at 8 on your great movie station, 21.
Everyone's turning 21. KTXA-TV, Fort Worth, Dallas.